I'm the technician in Leader of Life. I'm also teach the community how to build the light.
Yung apoy ang aming ginagamit, yung buho.
Mas maganda po kasi yung ganito, hindi nga siya namamatay sa hangin, hindi siya namamatay sa ulan. Kung panahon tag-ulan, okay lang ang mais, hindi tuloy-tuloy.
We're here in Angat Dam in Bulacan. We also check our product like street lights, solar lights, and solar lamps, so that we know if they are functions or they used by the community.
The Magat is the tribe live here for 100 years ago. They are the original inhabitants of this area in Angat Watershed Reservation.
Tapos maano ko po, maraming salamat din po sa ila. Dadalang na po ang bata.
Leader of Light is empowering communities to look for local parts, to build skills, to be able to access important lights for reading, for mobile charging, and for public lighting. Access to energy is more just about donations or getting a product manufactured abroad, putting it in ships, and then giving it to the people that will benefit from it. We're really trying to make a bottom-up approach. And the reason for the bottom-up approach is the 60% of the money spent in aid where it goes into logistics. Well, let's put it down in numbers. 20 million Filipinos don't have access to light. Another 700,000 was added to the 20 million because of Marawi. Correctional Institute for Women is the largest facility which keeps women that have been ruled by law to be incarcerated for crime. We manufacture hand-built solar lamps in the Correctional Institute for Women. And this is mostly for areas of there's the disaster or there's no place for them to be able to build this kind of assembly lines.
Masaya ako kasi isa kami sa makakapagbigay at makapag-aalay nito sa mga taga Marawi. Alam namin na makakatulong to sa kanila. Na nakita namin at na anong sitwasyon yung meron sila. Nakakulong nga lang kami pero alam namin yung hirap na wala kang ilaw. Pero dahil na ito sa mga ginagawa namin nakarating doon, masaya kami.
So Arnold basically goes there 3 times a week to be able to focus on the current project, which is Marawi. It's basically a war that just finished last year. The city of 700,000 has been evacuated and has been destroyed. Right now, they're all in shelter. So we are now giving access to lights for not only for the children to be able to continue their studies, but also public areas for women and children to have some kind of safety.
The idea was to film how the Litter of Light project was beginning to happen for the communities there in Marawi, and especially for the evacuation centers. Because what we have there so far with Litter of Light are lampposts set up in the ground zero or the ruins where the conflict ensued.
It's absolute destruction. It's you could see not only the physical, but you could almost feel the weeping of the city.
Right now, we are doing two steps. One is the emergency part, the short term, which is to bring 3,000 solar lanterns so that the children could be able to study, and 500 street lights to Marawi. Now, only one third of that will be built in the Manila area. Later on, we are now building a facility where the rest of the parts will be shipped there or sourced around the Mindanao area so that they can continue this livelihood of assembling it with the money going to pay the women there to have income, to be able to rise from this kind of post-conflict.
It brings a lot of dark thoughts, the darkness, basically. And it's so simple. You'd think that not having light was just simply an inconvenience, but it really was more than that for them.